Yay, good morning. Welcome to West Baldwin United Methodist Church online worship service. We're coming to you from our home in Standish, and of course this is Tony's office, so a little bit more intimate space than we've tried before. I'm Pastor Beau. This is my husband, Tony, the music director, our daughter, Hope, and occasionally the cats come to see us, although I don't know if you'll be able to see them. But Luna and Franklin come by every once in a while. We are celebrating today the baptism of the Lord. And so we welcome all of you to this online worship with a few announcements. If you look on our Facebook page online, you will find our worship materials if you'd like to be able to participate. We also send out a prayer list. If you would like to raise concerns, you can type them into the chat area at any time during this worship service. And we welcome that. If you would like to put things on the prayer list during the week, you can contact us at the information provided in the bulletin. You can also receive these and our newsletter and the bulletin materials emailed to you. If you would like, just contact us. We have immediately following this service a fellowship time on Zoom. If you'd like that connection information, please contact us, text or email us, and we will respond. And we also resume our Bible study now that the holidays have passed. So Friday at 9 a.m., we have our Advent and Epiphany study. It will conclude on this coming Friday, and we will be discussing what we want to do with our Bible study times as we go forward in the week to come between now and Lent. So if you have any suggestions, please contact us, let us know, and please join us in our Zoom Bible study format. You can get that information by contacting us. And so we can remember that there are no new birthdays or anniversaries this week. And so we can prepare our hearts and minds for worship with the prelude.
Praise the Lord with the sound of trumpet. Praise the Lord with the harp and lute. Praise the Lord with the gentle sound and flute. Praise the Lord in the field and forest. Praise the Lord in the city square. Praise the Lord anytime and anywhere. Praise the Lord in the wind and sunshine. Praise the Lord in the dark of night. Praise the Lord in the rain or snow or in the morning light. Praise the Lord in the deepest valley. Praise the Lord on the highest hill. Praise the Lord, never let your voice be still. Praise the Lord with the crashing cymbal. Praise the Lord with the pipe and string. Praise the Lord with the joyful songs you sing. Praise the Lord on a weekday morning. Praise the Lord on a Sunday noon. Praise the Lord by the light of sun or moon. Of sorrow, praise the Lord in the time of joy. Praise the Lord every moment, nothing let your praise destroy. Praise the Lord in the peace and quiet. Praise the Lord in your work or play. Praise the Lord everywhere and every way.
Please join us and the call to worship. Over the barren waters, God's Spirit moved like a bird. God spoke, and His word became light.
We remember our baptism and rejoice.
Joan of Arc, 15th century France, said, "Since God has commanded it, it was necessary that I do it."
The soldier baptizes his king.
In Jonah, Jonah says, "You threw me down to the bottom of the sea. The water was churning all around. I was completely covered. But you, Lord God, rescued me from that pit."
The servant, his Lord.
The Gospel of John says, "This is the one I told you would come. He is greater than I am, because he was alive before I was born."
John, his Savior.
St. Gregory of Nazianzus, 4th century Turkey, said, "Let us be buried with Christ by baptism in order to rise with him. Let us go down with him in order to be raised with him. Let us rise with him in order to be glorified with him."
The waters of the Jordan tremble.
In Genesis, Noah saw the dove return in the evening, holding in its beak a green leaf from an olive tree.
A dove hovers as a sign of witness.
Paul, in Acts, says John baptized people so that they would turn to God. But he also told them that someone else was coming, and that they should put their faith in him.
And the voice of the Father is heard.
Peter wrote in 2 Peter, "When we told you about the power and the return of our Lord Jesus Christ, we were not telling clever stories. God, our great and wonderful Father, truly honored him. We were there with Jesus and heard the voice speak from heaven."
This is my Son, in whom I am well pleased.
When I live in Christ and Christ lives in me, I am pleasing God as well. Amen. Our first hymn is found in our Faith We Sing hymnal, Baptized in Water, 2248. You can also find the words on hymnary.org.
Of salvation, trusting his promise, faithfully now God's praises we sing. Baptized in water, sealed by the Spirit, dead in the tomb which Christ our one with his rising, freedom here given, thankfully now God's praises we sing. Baptized in water, sealed by the Spirit, marked with the sign of Christ our born of one Father, we are his children, joyfully now God's praises we sing.
Please join me in the opening prayer. God of glory, we bless your holy name. Worthy to be praised. Emmanuel, you are with us now and always. Forgive our stubbornness when we resist your entering into our hearts. and for having little trust in you when our world seems dark. Open our spiritual eyes to see all around us the light of Christ, which overcomes all darkness, bringing joy to the world and peace on earth evermore. May your brightness shine through us and onto our families, neighbors, communities, and to the ends of the earth. May the word continue to inspire our minds and transform our lives as we pass on your light, so that others may know the power of your redeeming grace and love. Glory to God. Amen.
The scripture reading this morning, the first reading is from Genesis chapter 1, verses 1 through 5. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was barren, with no form of life. It was under a roaring ocean covered with darkness, but the Spirit of God was moving over the water. God said, "I command light to shine," and light started shining. God looked at the light and saw that it was good. He separated light from darkness and named the light day and the darkness night. Evening came and then morning. That was the first day. The second scripture reading is from Acts chapter 19, verses 1 through 7. When Apollos was in Corinth, Paul traveled across the hill country to Ephesus, where he met some of the Lord's followers. He asked them, "When you put your faith in Jesus, were you given the Holy Spirit?" "No," they answered. "We have never even heard of the Holy Spirit." "Then why were you baptized?" Paul asked. They answered, "Because of what John taught." Paul replied, "John baptized people so that they would turn to God, but he also told them that someone else was coming and that they should put their faith in him. Jesus is the one that John was talking about." After the people heard Paul say this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. Then Paul placed his hands on them. The Holy Spirit was given to them, and they spoke unknown languages and prophesied. They were about 12 men in this group.
The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Celebrating the baptism of the Lord, and we tried a new arrangement, as we will continue to do throughout this unusual time of worshiping together online. And I'll ask Tony if he would be willing to pour a little water from the pitcher into the shell that's on the table right in front of him. The waters of baptism. Remember your baptism and rejoice. Thank you. We're talking today about being blessed in our baptism. And it is not an accident that we move from our Advent and Christmas, the beginnings of our year, to the beginnings of the Christian faith. your baptism in the name of Jesus, your baptism by water and by the Spirit. This is a time of beginnings. It is a new year, 2021. Many of us are hopeful that this will be a better year than last year. We have a new presidency, and that has changes in our politics. We can mourn the occurrences of this last week, but we can also remember to keep a bit of distance. We are not subjects of this kingdom. We are subjects of the kingdom of heaven. And we can wonder that when Christ returns, what will that transition of power be like? What will that transition of all the kingdoms of the earth under the rule of the kingdom of heaven? What will that be like? We went through our Christmas and Advent preparations of waiting, finding waiting as a blessing, waiting for the blessings of answered prayers, waiting on God and the Spirit's leading. And so we begin our time with Jesus as the center of our stories of our Christian year with his baptism. It's the beginning of his public ministry, the beginning of Christian life when we follow Jesus, and it has the symbolism we heard in Acts written by Luke about Paul. The symbolism of water and spirit, of the name of Jesus, and of the laying on of hands. All of these come to us from the first church. There are, as I reckoned it, three major blessings. Well, let's call it four major blessings of our baptism. The first is that we are under a new covenant relationship with God. We are no longer under the law and trying to keep the law. Those that did at the time of Jesus, personal ministry, thought that they had figured out how to do that. And Jesus came in part to tell them, no, you missed it. You missed something. But the new covenant was told to us way back in the prophets. Jeremiah said that that God had told him there would be a new covenant that was written on our hearts. So we wouldn't have to have faith because God would be with us, inside us. We wouldn't have to speak to one another and teach them about God because God would be present with us. In part, that is the Holy Spirit. And in completion, that is the kingdom of heaven. This covenant is sealed by water and the Spirit, sometimes seen as fire. We make vows in our baptism. If you have a hymnal and you are looking in it, you can find on page 34 from our baptism liturgy the things we promise or that are promised on our behalf if we were infant baptized. And they are no less important. And these are a part of our part of the covenant. A covenant is a legal agreement, a binding document. We offer something and God offers something. And as we know, God is the one that makes it possible for us to offer anything. But what we must offer, we say these words, renounce the spiritual forces of wickedness, reject the evil powers of the world, repent of our sin, accept the freedom and power God gives us to resist evil injustice and oppression in whatever forms they present themselves. Confess Jesus Christ as Savior. Put our whole trust in His grace. Promise to serve Him as Lord. In union with the whole church, which Christ has opened to everyone, everywhere. By the grace given, remain faithful members of Christ's church and serve as representatives of Christ in the world until His return. These are weighty things. These are things not to take lightly. This is life in Christ. To resist evil, to stand against oppression, to take a stand. Some of God's promises, and there are so many, that is why we keep returning to Scripture, but just a few. God, in Revelations about the end of the end times, the kingdom of heaven, says that He will make all things new, restore all creation, including us, the resurrection. There will be a new kingdom of heaven come down to the new earth. God will live among God's people, and God's people will be God's family. God promised to wipe away all the tears from our eyes. There will be no more death, suffering, crying, or pain forever. There is the promise of eternal life. God will take care of us, and all things will work out under God's careful eye. God offers healing. God offers help and guidance when we ask for it and need it. God grants wisdom when we ask for it. Only through God can we experience God's peace, joy, love. God offers His power and strength to accomplish God's work. And there's hope in this kind of future. Even when things around us may seem dark and full of despair and hopelessness, God's kingdom is coming. And there is our hope. Second blessing of our baptism is receiving the Holy Spirit. In this, God marks us as God's own. It is something that everyone can see. It is a spiritual tattoo, a spiritual claiming that we are God's. The Spirit nourishes this life of faith until we grow in what our Wesleyan tradition calls sanctification. We grow closer in holiness, closer to relationship with Jesus, closer to God's image in which we were made, brighter and brighter. The light will shine through us, without our own stuff getting in the way. It means receiving the Spirit that we participate fully in Christ's death and in His resurrection. God became human. God became incarnate, wrapped in flesh, so that He might show us, through Jesus the Christ, death and new life. And in baptism, we die under the waters And we are reborn as new creations as we come out of the waters. This is our truth. This is our story. This is our hope. We die to the parts of us that are old, the parts of us that are false, the parts of us that are selfish and self-willed. The newness of life is to come into the mind of Christ, the will of God, to be constantly seeking through the Spirit's presence what God's will for us is and the strength to do it. And finally, there is unity as a blessing of baptism. Unity is something we try to understand through the unity of God in God's self. God is a triune God, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, Creator, Christ. Holy Spirit. Those three exist in one person of God. We are brought into that unity. We are brought into unity with God so that we can have that closeness and understanding as much as our minds are able. And we have that unity with one another. It does not matter if you've grown up your whole lives in community with each other or if you have just run into each other somewhere. We are family. We serve the same Lord. We are destined for the same kingdom. And so we can rejoice in unity with each other. These are the blessings. Because I am baptized, I can say in my past as an infant that the Holy Spirit was given a pathway into me. As I was raised in the church, confirmed, accepting the baptism as adult, reiterating the vows that were taken when I was an infant, and claiming them for myself as a young adult, a teen. As we move into my present, that I am continuing ever, always, the journey towards and into God, because God's mysteries are infinite. I cannot search them without God's help. I cannot make sense of them without God's interpretation. And there is always more for me to understand. And the future? The future is a peaceful kingdom of true justice, true love for one another, true concern that every single person be everything that God created them to be. And that we help one another to do that for no other reason than that the help is needed and we can give it. These are promises of that kingdom. That is our true home. Perhaps at times like these, we can remember that this is not our home and that this is a place that is a classroom to teach us. Amen. We continue our worship now by lifting up our joys and concerns. Again, the prayer list is mailed out, emailed out and distributed so that you can receive it. We also accept prayer requests. We did hear that from Paul in Maryland, that the treatment that he received that had reestablished the normal heart rhythm after his after his suffering with the illness of COVID-19, it lasted about 5 days, and then the AFib returned. So there's the exploration of more treatments for that. We ask for God's healing presence, wisdom, and discernment. We have also heard from Susan and the pain of recovery from her knee surgery and the preparations mentally and physically for the next knee to be done. We ask for God's healing presence there. We have continued to hear of Dot Hart. She has continued to search through doctors and testing, and they have no clear identification that she has a cancer, and yet they have recommended treatment as of cancer. And so she is in a deep state of needing wisdom and discernment, and we just ask for God's comforting presence with her. I believe those are all the newest requests that had come to the prayer chain. Are there? Yes.
Paul in Maryland raises a joy to have Paul back to work after 4 months.
Paul back to work. After 4 months of being isolated for COVID, from the beginning of being exposed and being tested for COVID to the illness, 4 months, such a joy to return to work, to a work that is a vocation and not a paycheck, to work that is life-affirming and giving and spirit-wrought. And we rejoice with Paul and Marilyn in this, and with God and the angels. Others? Then let us be in the spirit of prayer. Lord, we know that you hold us in the palm of your hands. We can feel your strength. We do not always realize that we can ask to have that strength, what we can carry of it in our little thimble, that we might make it through each day of our lives, following your will. We ask for your strength and comfort, your healing for all those that have raised concerns. We have concerns in our heart we did not raise, and we lift them up to you now. And we say together, Lord, hear our prayers. We remember also the joys that you have brought to us, the healings, returnings to work, answered prayers, the beauty of our natural world, the love and companionship, and even the human touch when it is able to be given in these difficult pandemic times. The comforts that we are offered and that we can offer one another. And we hold on through this because we know, we do not know how many pages are left in the book of life, of this life, but we know that the last page is filled with all your promises completed. A life with no more grief or suffering or sickness or dying. A life with you. A life of joy and peace forever. We have joys on our hearts that we did not raise, and we lift them up to you now. And we say together, Lord, hear our praise. And we continue with the prayer that Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. We continue our worship by lifting up our tithes and offerings. You may make your offerings and tithes and gifts to the church at the address provided on our bulletin materials, 26 Douglas Hill Road in West Baldwin, Maine. But we can also use this as a time to reflect on all the little ways in which we have helped one another and blessed one another, and the ways in which we can be of a blessing to others. We are always blessed by God in order to be a blessing to others. We will follow the offertory by our doxology and then our prayer of dedication.
Thousand hills, the wealth in every mine. He owns the rivers and the rocks and rills, the sun and stars that shine. Wonderful riches more than tongue can tell. He is my Father, so they're mine as well. He owns the cattle on a thousand hills. I know that he will care for me. Rocks and rills, the sun and stars that shine. Wonderful riches more than tongue can tell. He is my master, though they shine as well. He owns the cattle on a thousand hills. I know that he will care for me.
God of the desert, of the stripping away, We experience the pain of losing people, identity, and things in order to return to the essence of all things, your sacred arms. When we commit to the simplicity of the essential and let go the rest, we also clear the way for our relationship to you. Take us and our offerings as you will. Amen. And our hymn of peace is God of the Sparrow, God of the Whale, in our hymnals number 122. Spirituality. We release everything we think we know to rest in the source of all truth. We renounce our former lives, our mindless thoughts, and finally our ideas about God, so God can be God. The call of the way of Jesus is to let go, let go, let go, and let go some more. On every level of our lives, the desert has the power to open our hearts to what our minds cannot understand. Go further into the desert and let go.
Amen.
Shalom to you now. Shalom, my friends. May God's full mercies bless you, my friends, in all your living and through your loving. Christ be your shalom. Christ be your shalom. Shalom to you now. Shalom, my friends. May God's full mercies bless you, my friend, in all your living and through your loving. Christ be your shalom. Christ be your shalom. May the good Lord bless and keep you, whether near or far away. May they find that long-awaited golden day today. May your troubles all be small ones, and your fortune 10 times 10. May the good Lord bless and keep you till we meet again. May you walk with sunlight shining and a bluebird in every tree. May there be a silver lining back of every cloud you see. Fill your dreams with sweet tomorrows, never mind what might have been. May the good Lord bless and keep you till we meet again. May the good Lord bless and keep you.